These are all pictures of a type of tick that can transmit Lyme disease to people. All these pictures are of ticks found on humans in Ontario in 2021. In fact, one website alone has positively identified 1,459 of this type of tick on humans in Ontario in 2021 alone. If you camp regularly in the Ontario parks, you probably already know about the tick problem. If you don't know about it, you really should. The black-legged tick can infect people with Lyme disease, which can cause chronic health issues, paralysis, and in some rare cases, even death. Today, we're going to be talking about the types of ticks in Ontario, Lyme disease, how to protect yourself, how to remove a tick, and how to protect your pets. And we'll also show you a great online resource where you can help with the research. Now, I want to make this very clear from the start. We're not medical experts, and we're not giving medical advice. We gathered all this information from experts, such as the Centers for Disease Control, Health Canada, Public Health Ontario, Ontario Parks, and a website called eTick.ca. And we're going to talk about that website a little bit more later on.
The most common ticks in Ontario are the American dog tick, also known as the wood tick, and the black-legged tick, also known as the deer tick. Only the black-legged tick can transmit Lyme disease. Ticks in Ontario can transmit other diseases, but nothing as serious as Lyme disease. Ticks can be found in high grasses, woodlands, and bushes. They can't fly, they walk, and they jump. They have spread across the province so easily by latching on to mammals and birds, which can carry them far distances. Some famous people have recently talked about their battles with Lyme disease. Avril Lavigne said she has been battling Lyme disease since 2014. She said that she was bedridden for nearly a year and a half.
Shania Twain said she contracted Lyme disease in 2003, which caused her to develop a vocal cord disorder. She said that for several years, she was concerned that she might not ever be able to sing again.
In 2020, Justin Bieber said that he had Lyme disease and said it's been a rough couple of years.
Lyme disease is a bacterial infection, and the only way you can get Lyme disease is by being bitten by a black-legged tick. You won't feel the tick bite, and you won't feel it feeding on you. The most common symptoms found in almost 80% of the people with Lyme disease is an expanding skin rash or a bullseye rash, which can appear between 3 to 30 days after the bite. It can be the size of a loonie or right up to the size of a dinner plate. Other early symptoms might include flu-like symptoms, headache, fatigue, fever, stiff neck, muscle aches, and joint pain. However, 20% of the people never get a rash or have any symptoms whatsoever. And that's a problem because missing treatment in the initial stages makes it much more difficult to treat. In the initial stages, it can often be treated with antibiotics. If not treated, the symptoms might disappear all on their own, but more serious issues will come up within weeks or months afterwards. Problems with the nervous system, heart, breathing, balance, short-term memory, or arthritis. It is potentially a crippling condition, and there is no cure. First of all, you need to know when you're in black-legged tick territory. Public Health Ontario updates a map each year that shows the most likely areas in the province to contract Lyme disease. Another excellent resource is eTick.ca. It's a website that users can submit pictures of ticks that they found. The site will try to identify the type of tick. It will also state where it was found, the date it was found, and on what type of host it was on, such as a human or an animal. You can check out their map to see where all the submissions came from. They also have an app for Android and iOS. It shows that almost anywhere in Ontario, you can find black-legged ticks. We'll bring up the eTick website here. Here's an awesome picture of a tick right here. The best way to use this is through your phone, because if you're going to submit a picture of a tick, you can take a picture of it with your phone. The date and location are automatically attached to the picture when you send it to eTick.ca. They give you a little information here on how to see tick records, how to remove a tick, and a photographic guide that gives you some pointers on how to best take a picture for your submission. If you click on the map up here, it'll take you to a map of North America, so it will show you where the ticks have been located in Canada. And as you can see, each of these has a number, and that number is how many ticks have been submitted in that area. So down right here in really southern Ontario, 7,676. So you just zoom into that, and it spreads it out and shows you where they are located. And as you can see, it goes pretty far up north. We got Thunder Bay over here, Sioux Lookout, Red Lake, Grassy Narrows, all ticks located up there. If we go down to Southern Ontario, let's go to a place like Pinery Provincial Park. There's Pinery right there on the shores of Lake Huron. Anywhere you see a number, that means there's two more of those green dots underneath there. So you can zoom in a little more and it'll show them. So let's have a click on this tick right here. And there's a black-legged tick. It was found on trail at Pinery Provincial Park on 31st of March, 2021, and it was on an animal. If you want to see a picture of it, you can click on the ID number right there, and it'll show the pictures that were submitted. It shows us on an animal, and it was actually on a dog. Click on the picture, and there's the pictures that the person submitted. You can go back, have a look at another one at Pinery. There's Riverside Campground right there. Black-legged tick on a trail, and it was found on a human. This looks like a really small picture of a tick. But still, eTick.ca was able to identify what type of tick that was. Now, to get more of a numbers type search, you can go into public data, and let's again look at the black-legged tick in Ontario. And we will say from January 1st of 2021 to December 31st of 2021. And that will be all of 2021. Apply, and you will see that for the black-legged ticks, there were 2,437 submitted. 908 were on animals, 70 were in the free environment, and 1,459 were on humans. So again, you can go down the list here. If you notice, this is December 28th. This one's December 26th. So they are still active in the winter months. They will still feed throughout the winter. As more people learn about this site, there will be many more submissions, and the numbers will definitely be going up. The site will then have a much more accurate description of the tick issue in Ontario.
Here are some steps to take when you are in a tick habitat. Wear light-colored clothing. It makes the ticks easier to spot on you. Wear closed footwear, socks, and a long shirt. Tuck your shirt into your pants. Tuck your pants into your socks. Use an insect repellent that has DEET or keratin. Put it on your clothes and any exposed skin. Follow your manufacturer's instructions. Search your body enclosed for ticks at least once a day, paying special attention to the groin, belly button, ears, scalp, and knees. Use a mirror to check the back of your body or have someone else check it for you. Don't forget to tick check children in your care. Doing a daily check when you're getting ready for bed is a convenient time as you're getting undressed already. Have readily available tools to remove a tick. A couple of years ago, I decided to put together a simple splinter tick kit for $20. This is what I put together. I got a little Tupperware bin just to keep things safe and dry. In here, I've got some antiseptic spray in case you're not near any soap and water, and some hand sanitizer as well. I have this magnifying glass. This is a little bit more heavy duty. It lights up because most of the time it's in the evening that we find the ticks, so I find the lighting isn't as good, so I'd like to have this, but you could just use a regular magnifying glass. I've got some containers that I collected from the craft section of Dollarama just to put the ticks in so we can take them to the doctors if we need to. You can just use a Ziploc bag as well. Here's a few Band-Aids and some cotton rounds if you need them. I have two types of tweezers here. Very fine tip ones for those teeny, teeny, tiny ones, and just regular tweezers for the larger ones. They both can come in handy. And I just had this little tick card from the vet's office many years ago. It just shows you the different size of the ticks. And there you have it. And one other thing that I didn't add in on this tick kit, but you should have, is probably some antibiotic ointment. You could just pick this up at the drugstore. Just throw that in there as well. And there you're all set. Tick kit good to go. To remove a tick that is attached to you or a pet, you want to use fine-tip tweezers to grasp the tick as close to the skin as possible. Pull the tick out slowly with even pressure to ensure the head is removed and the body is not crushed.
This is a tick that attached to Cheryl at Presqu'ile Provincial Park in 2020. Got him straight out.
Good job. Pop him in there.
There he's in there.
Nice.
Then wash the area with soap and water. Put the tick in a Ziploc bag or empty pill bottle. You can take a picture of it and submit it to eTick.ca to identify what kind of tick it is.
A tick bite doesn't necessarily mean that Lyme disease will follow.
Not all black-legged ticks carry Lyme disease.
It's estimated that 20 to 40% of all black-legged ticks in Ontario carry the bacteria necessary to cause Lyme disease.
According to the CDC, transmission of the infection is unlikely to occur before 36 hours of attachment.
So that means prompt removal of the tick is important to prevent disease. If you've been bitten or suspect you've been bitten by a black-legged tick and you experience symptoms, see a doctor immediately. If you can, bring the tick with you. The doctor will be able to send the tick off to public health to determine if it actually carries Lyme disease. You can also get it tested yourself by going to genetics.ca, and for $50 plus shipping, they will tell you if that tick carries Lyme disease.
There is no vaccine for humans for Lyme disease. There is one being tested.
According to the journal Science Translational Medicine, reported in November of 2021, there are trials being conducted right now on guinea pigs. And I mean real guinea pigs, like the cute furry little rodents.
Poor things.
Yale University researchers have developed a vaccine that is delivered by the same mRNA technology that is used to fight COVID-19. Lots more animal testing and human testing still has to be done. So it's a long way off before this is going to be something available for humans. Let's hope this vaccine tests well and becomes available soon.
Pets can also get Lyme disease with similar side effects as people, but there are ways to protect your pet. For dogs, there are chewable treatments such as Bravecto, NexGard, and Simparica Trio. The medicine absorbs into the dog's bloodstream, but then the tissue fluids just under the skin. A biting tick eats it and will die and usually fall off within 10 hours. There are also topical treatments for dogs such as Canine Advantix 2, Bravecto Topical Solution, or a flea and tick collar like Seresto. For cats, there are normally just topical protections such as Bravecto for cats, Remolution Plus for cats, Frontline Plus for cats, and Seresto Collar for cats. A topical treatment is applied to the skin of a dog or a cat, which repels the ticks. The dog doesn't actually get bitten, and the tick jumps up rather quickly. Check with your vet just to make an informed decision about what's right for your pets.
In late 2020, we forgot to keep up on Kingston's monthly dose of Simparica Trio.
It's very bad.
We went to Pinery for Thanksgiving, and over that weekend, he ended up having 30 ticks latch onto him and feed off of him. So we were picking a lot of ticks off of him while we were there. And unfortunately, we didn't find some of them until we got home because they fed for a while and they got bigger than we noticed them at home. So that means the ticks went into our truck and they came into our house also.
Luckily, I used a large light-colored blanket, so I was able to see when the ticks dropped off.
And when we pulled them out, we got pretty experienced at it. And
it's like pulling a dandelion out of the ground. You pull it out and one... And you hear that pop.
Yeah, it
you
know does.
You got it all.
It does a little pop sound. So, that was unfortunate. But fortunately, Kingston had no ill effects from it. I think we got them all off quick enough. Now, we're not trying to scare you from going outdoors.
No.
We're just trying to show you some simple steps you can take to protect yourself, your family, and your pets from getting Lyme disease. Do we go out with long pants and having our socks tucked into our pants for every hike we go on? No, we don't. And do we wear bug repellent with DEET in it all the time we go on hikes? No, we don't do that either. The main things we do is we try to stay on the paths and we don't walk in long grasses and we do our daily tick check. They're very simple steps to make sure your camping experience is memorable for the right reasons. So let's be safe out there.
And don't forget your tweezers.
And we'll see you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.